Another year's gone by. I'm so glad you're with me. The way you lift me up with the love you give me. It's good to know that you'll be mine when days are blue. Oh, what a dream come true.
Welcome to the Orange is the New Black podcast. I am Rob Southgate. With me is
Martha Southgate.
And today we are talking season 5, episode 3. Pissters.
Linda begins to see the prison in a new light, while Judy grows desperate to escape. With darkness falling, the inmates compile a list of demands.
And it's called Pissters, which is...
That's so funny.
Awesome. How did we never hear that term before? I mean,
that's a really good question.
I mean, really, when you think about it, like, it's always like an old joke that, you know, women always go to the bathroom together and whatever. Pissters is just the perfect name.
It is.
So, well played, Orange is the New Black.
Okay, this episode to me from this season had a completely different feel, and it made me want to cry I don't know how many times.
Really?
It just was very... touching, like the last two.
The emotions aren't running the same way, so I can see.
And the last two, it was just chaos and let me see what I can get and let me see what I can get away with. And
right.
Here, you know, when they were compiling their list of demands, it's like you just see them so much more as people and as individuals all.
Yeah, just especially that scene.
Wanting the same things.
Especially the scene with Suzanne when she...
Oh, my gosh.
When she was blocking off the area where Pusey had
all
died.
All the feels in the whole
that
world.
That was really hard. And I love how they played that when everybody went silent and was watching.
So going over there. And,
oh, my
and,
gosh.
And, you know, it was like the first time that we see people really coming to her, like really getting where she is. And
when even Gloria came and knelt
and just
down
so gently gave them the food. Oh,
it's just really
there
great.
Was
that
just
was
a different
feels.
Level in this episode than we've seen in the last two. And I'm not saying the last two weren't fantastic episodes,
spectacular episodes,
but this one just had a different level of emotion and depth to it that I just really appreciated. And even like Pensatucky or. I don't know. It just seemed like there was a little bit more feels.
Okay. Well, like I said, the emotions are running a different way than they have the last two. So now it's not as wild and there's going to be a lot more emotion coming into it for the inmates.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's nighttime now.
Yeah.
They're coming down from all this craziness with a lot of, you know, fear going into mm-hmm. the next step. And there's this promise of, you know, demands, which apparently they hadn't really thought of before.
Yeah, it didn't occur to them they were actually going to get demands.
Yeah. So, I mean, it is. It is a very different episode. Once again, we're still not out of this situation. Mm-hmm. I don't know if this is going to be the whole season.
Yeah.
But that's three full episodes of this situation, and I don't see any end in sight.
No.
Judy King's still stuck in there. I thought for sure when she went through that window and was running, I thought that there would be some way that she would slip out.
Mm-hmm.
And
I was actually surprised that since the first episode, that when they had the guards held down, they saw that nobody was coming. Why didn't they find a way out?
Right.
Because that you would think that
especially
would be
if they
your
see the back way is open.
They locked themselves in.
Two seasons ago, they had that opportunity to escape, but maybe they don't want
to
be
the lake.
But maybe they don't want to be escaped convicts. If you're an escaped convict, you're going to increase your sentence. And like Gloria said, first demand has to be amnesty.
Yes.
No extra time for what's going on here. Mm-hmm. This is a protest. Now, granted,
they didn't do that though, right? Their first demand was that the guards be fired and trained.
Yes. Yes. So they didn't say amnesty on there first, which is a mistake.
Yeah, I think they said it second.
Yeah.
But still, I mean, even I don't think that there's, when you're doing a list like that, they're all important. Like, they're saying, except for the freaking Cheetos, you know, they're saying that these are all
Cheetos and Takis.
What are Takis?
Takis, it's a snack food. I don't know. We've never eaten them. I've seen them, though.
So,
the name sounds like little tacos, so I kind of like that.
I'm going to have to look at them next time. So, I don't feel bad at all for Judy King.
No.
Not in the least.
No.
And Suzanne and
but
Maureen.
But she even called herself out as a one percenter in it. It's tough to have a lot of sympathy for her and her situation, the way she talks to people, the way she acts.
Yes. And Linda is killing me in this episode. She was really funny, and she was so good with the other inmates when she was explaining who she was and what she was in there for. Like, she handled herself so well.
Right.
And but then we see why, because she's actually shady.
Oh, yeah, she is. But we always knew she was.
Right. But then to see it, it's like, you're a con artist.
Yeah. 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 That sorority scene. First of all, our daughter is never going to join a sorority.
There you go.
It's anything like that.
You heard it here first, Molly.
That was awful. I hope she didn't hear it here first. Unless she's secretly watching Orange is the New Black.
Is she?
I really hope not at 10. But that sorority situation, mm-hmm. Yuck. Linda with the other girl, the one that died.
Yeah.
I mean, it just, like, I knew something was going to happen when they went out there, and I knew Linda was just going to hide it.
Mm-hmm. She did more than hide it. She took over.
Yeah, but she hid it from the cops. She lied to
the
cops.
Well, I said she did more than that.
Right. She manipulated.
If she had just done that, you would be able to say, well, you know what? I get it. She was scared. It wasn't her fault. It's not her fault that girl died.
No.
What came after is her fault. Shows,
oh, yeah,
oh, I'm going to take, I'm an opportunist.
The head went off, and Linda stepped right into it. This just in, here's the, this is actually something that popped up when I looked up Takis. Mini Takis, Fuego Hot, Chili Pepper, and Lime Flavored Rolled Tortilla Snacks.
Oh.
But here's the best part. Cheetos and Takis, these spicy chips, were the subject of last year's Hot Cheetos and Takis, which featured young kids rapping about the spicy snacks. So there you go. Takis and Flamin' Hot Cheetos. That's a thing. The more you know.
Yes.
So, okay. Let's go back. So the Linda thing. Let's talk about that first.
Okay.
So we have the sorority scene. We get to see how that thing plays out. We get to see her true colors there. Mm-hmm. Then we see her here, and she's not doing a great job of hiding this, even though she's just like a con artist and lying. How they're not all of a sudden saying, you don't talk like you're a prisoner.
Either does Piper. They just think she's either does So-So.
I guess they just think she's
another privileged white woman. Judy doesn't.
Yeah.
They're just going, oh, here's another one.
Right. And, okay.
But so she said,
Caputo sees her.
Yeah. Oh yeah, he did.
And they know now.
Yeah.
That she is.
That she's infiltrated.
Yes, that she's.
But she's not helping them. Right. Oh, I thought you meant like Caputo sees now that she's there, but Caputo doesn't know that she's not helping them.
No.
She's not. She's there to save her ass.
Right.
She's not there to
protect. Well, I'm sure Caputo is thinking that. I'm sure he's. Oh, you mean to save them?
Yeah.
Well, we don't know what's going to happen.
She's infiltrated.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, she's not.
No, she's going
to
save herself.
She's not there to help them.
That's what she does. That's her MO.
So, but her lines, she's written really well, better than Piper.
Yeah.
And she's hilarious.
I totally buy her character 100%. Yes.
And when she was saying the thing about the food, she's like, wait a second. On the thing, it said parsley. It showed parsley. And I don't think parsley's ever touched this plate. And they're all just staring at her. And, oh, it's so funny.
Yeah. Yeah. And it's like her list of demands. She's like, well, but see, even that, she knew the business end of it. And I would think at least Piper would be like, even though she knows, would be like, wait a minute, you must work for the company, because she hasn't revealed why she was there. She hasn't revealed who she is.
No, she did. She said she was there for forgery. She said, I can counterfeit $10 bill. I can.
Well, no, no. I mean, with Piper and Alex, they know that she is not an inmate. They helped her.
They know who she is.
Do they?
Of course they do. She had her badge.
They just didn't know that she was dating Caputo.
Now they do.
Yeah.
But they knew she worked for the prison.
Yeah.
And they found her in the bathroom in her business suit. And they said, well, you're going to have to blend if this is what you want to do. And that's what they've the whole first two episodes were them training her.
Yeah. Well, I knew that. I just didn't know if they knew that she was a consultant or something that was there, or if she was like trying to sell them foodstuffs or something, no. You know, but she works directly for the company and she's dating Caputo.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I don't think so. Maybe they did know, but not to the full extent.
I'm surprised they let her go that they didn't stop her when Boo was going over to feed the guards,
yeah,
knowing that Caputo's in there. And she jumped up and said, oh, I want to go.
Yeah, but they didn't see that she was dating Caputo until they were gone from the table.
Ah, that makes sense. Because then
she was already
gone,
and that's when they found it. And they're like, oh, okay. Look at this.
Yeah, because I would think that would be something you would want to stop her from doing.
Yes. Well, and those guards, we've got the guards locked up, and they're trying to figure out a way out. And there's no real way out. And this idea of maybe we could choke him, when he said that, my first thought was, well, you might get one, but there's hundreds. Mm-hmm. What good? So you're going to choke one out?
Right.
Or you're going to grab one and hold them hostage? They're going to say, fine.
Yeah.
There's hundreds of us and seven of you, and you've got one of us.
Right.
It's not the same thing.
Right.
We still have seven of you. So it's not very well thought out, which is, you know,
well, the one wanted to set the place on fire.
Right.
And I loved that.
I feel terrible for the guy that needs his insulin, though. He's like, look, I need this. And he's like, I'm going to go into shock. They're like, yeah, well, whatever. No, that guy needs that.
It's kind of a big deal.
Yeah. Why would they? Well, they're just holding it because they're mad at the guards.
Right. Artesian. She, I loved her description when they were doing the, okay, if I set this on fire scenario.
Yeah.
And she's like, well, it wouldn't be that bad because we just suffocate, you know? And then she said, it's not like being out in an open field because there, you know, as the body go, like you wouldn't believe how the fluids come out.
Well, that's because she was military.
Right. But they were staring at her like, who the heck are we locked in here with? But I just thought that was really funny that her character was so like.
Yeah, right.
On point with, you know. Yeah,
Dexter-ish.
Yeah.
Okay. We got a little hint.
Oh, of WD?
Well, no. Well, okay. We can do that one first if you want.
Oh, what was your hint?
Well, my hint was we keep talking about who took the gun.
Yeah, who hit her on the head.
And my thought was Coates.
Who's up in the freaking air vent
watching Pexitani.
What are you calling her?
Did I get it wrong again? What's her name? Doggett.
Why don't we call her Doggett? Or you can call her by her first name.
Pensatucky.
We'll call her Doggett. Tiffany.
Tiffany.
But let's call her Doggett.
Doggett. Okay. Mm-hmm. You know I'll forget that again.
Okay.
But we got a clue about the shooter. Or who took the gun, I mean. Not the shooter. We know who the shooter is. But I'm trying to remember who said it. When they said the inmates have a gun.
Well, the one said, I don't think she does.
But who said that? Oh, it was
Artesian
that said it.
Yes.
She's the one that said.
Yeah, I don't think they have one.
I don't think so. Do you think that she knows something about the gun getting taken from Daya, or was it just that she knows?
No, they're
just putting their hand in there.
Yes, because they were using their finger in her jacket.
Okay.
And she said, I don't think they have a gun.
Because when she said it, my first thought was that she had a clue.
Mm-mm.
And then
that was a clue. Yeah.
When that other inmate walked by, obviously pretending, I think that might have been when they were like, okay, there's no gun. But there was a gun.
There was.
Somebody has a gun. So even though they're thinking like, oh, we're safe, you're not safe.
Mm-mm.
Somebody has a gun.
And oh my gosh, when Gloria was in the kitchen with that giant knife.
Oh,
and I'm
gosh.
Thinking, oh, this is not going to end well. I'm like, don't kill Gloria. And I really Diana thought somebody was going to kill her.
Like, why don't you go stir things up? That's what you're good at.
Yeah. She is trying to keep her out of trouble.
Yes.
She's having her help in the kitchen, but
kind of too late.
But the knife, I really thought when she set it down and walked away, I was like, don't kill Gloria.
No kidding.
I really thought that somebody was going to stab her.
I'm kind of hoping we don't have any more deaths for a while. Just because the Poussé one was so shocking.
Yeah.
And if you go over the other seasons, we've typically had a death here and there. Right now, I don't, especially something like that. If Gloria had gotten killed, it would have been really hard to watch. I need a little break from that, I think.
Mm-hmm.
Because they're not really turning on each other either. Although I'm sure it's got to be leading that way. At some point, one of these episodes, if this continues through the whole season, there's got to be an episode when they start going at each other. Because think about it. They're trapped in a box.
Right.
And they're going to get along, and then at some point they're not going to get along. And that could also be what the law enforcement is banking on. Like, they're going to self-destruct. Mm-hmm. We just got to let them live in there for a
yeah.
while.
Well, wait till those the guards who are stuck in that room, and they're feeding them that slop, which is going to make them have to poop. And
yeah,
then
right.
She's like, well, I'll just bring them a second.
Poopsters.
I'll give them a second bucket, but imagine being in those close quarters. They're barely clothed. They've got a reek to high heaven.
Right.
And now they're going to be pooping in there.
What'd you call it? Diarrhea Wellington? What did you call it?
Well, no, Beef Poopington or something.
Beef Poopington. That's a funnier name.
Or Poop Wellington.
Poop Wellington. That's it. That's a great name. I think that might have to be a hashtag for something we've set out. Mm-hmm. Poop Wellington.
So we've got.
If Denny's served Beef Wellington,
ew,
I would have Wellington. To call it Poop Wellington.
So
because that moons over my hammy.
We have.
It's a great name.
Nikki.
Yes.
And Lorna overseeing the drugs.
Yes.
And so they get to play doctor. I have a headache. Oh, I have this.
I love
oh,
this, dude. Dr. Nikki was great.
Yeah. So that was fun. And then. What else do we have? Gloria's back in the kitchen. And
yeah, like things are settling kind of into yeah. the old routine.
Suzanne and Maureen are friends and back in the population a little bit.
Maureen's
you know?
Eye is freaking
I
me out.
I can't even look.
It's freaking me out. When I was a kid, I remember I was like in third
I don't
grade
even want to hear
or
this
fourth
story.
Grade. And this one kid showed up after the weekend and he totally had an eye that was like that. Like it was shut. It was all black and blue and it was sticking way off
and
his
what
face.
What happened?
And he sat right across from me. I asked him and he was like, oh, I was playing baseball and got hit with a ball or something. I'll be fine. I would not be fine. Here I'm 40.
I'm not fine
I'm
even hearing about
I'm
it.
I'm traumatized
yeah.
still by this kid with his bulging purple eye.
Not fine.
Yeah. Gross.
But it's nice to see them. They're back together. They're not stuck alone in the medical ward anymore.
Yes.
And I'm not sure what they're going to do about that guy with the eye, with the stroke.
The stroke guy. Well, the doctor guy did take him back. So maybe he can at least do something. I mean, he's going to have brain damage. Absolutely.
I don't think there's any way he could come back from one that's severe.
But they
can
get
severe.
The tape off his face and maybe make him more comfortable.
Less Meg Ryan.
Yeah, less Meg Ryan. So, I mean, there's at least that. But this guy was a monster.
Yeah.
So when this all shakes out and there's, you know, they find out about what he did, he doesn't have a really great life ahead of him, no matter what.
Mm-hmm.
So at least they can get the tape off his face, though. That'd yeah. be nice. That
and
was
some
great.
Clothes
that
on.
Was awesome. When wasn't it Judy ran up to him thinking
yeah.
it was help? And then
and she flipped around. She's like, eh.
He's like, rah.
Yeah.
I thought he was dead, but he was alive.
Oh, yeah, no, he's not dead.
Is like, rah.
Grunt. Yeah, that
oh,
would be
crazy.
A bit unsettling in that environment, especially.
It's crazy.
Who How else?
I got another one where Red said, I got to go back and feed the eyebrow. That was awesome. That was awesome.
That was so funny. And I about died laughing when she said that. I'm like, oh my gosh, she's talking about
Flora. Yeah, and Flora's called Red Heatmiser.
Heatmiser, yep. That one was fantastic. So they're working together to dig up dirt.
Yeah, and this goes back to what you were saying, the clue.
Piscatella, and then she said, who is this? Look, I have this badge for...
WD.
And I forget the name.
Wendell? Wendell Davis. I have no idea.
No.
WD. Okay, so I have a theory on this.
Okay.
I have a feeling that is going to turn out to be... Maybe it was Piscatella's boyfriend, and they had a bad breakup or something. Maybe they were having a relationship, and you're not allowed to have relationships while you're working there. Because remember the other two guards that quit because they were in their relationship. Maybe they, you know, okay, we're not allowed to do this. So he's like mourning the loss of the other guy. That's why he has his badge and he has it tattooed on his arm.
That could totally be.
And that could be what they're what they end up digging up is like there's a tragic story there.
Right. Because why else would he put his initials on his wrist?
Right. And maybe the guy died. Maybe it's, you know, something happened to this guy and he died. And instead of getting a tear tattooed on his face, he got DW or WD tattooed on his arm.
Hmm.
It still felt like he was signaling Red.
Yeah.
So I can't quite figure that out.
But I don't know if he was.
It felt like it, but I don't know if he was. But it sure felt like it.
I just think it was a plot device. I think you were just reacting to the fact that they were making a point of showing it, that they were like, oh, wait, was he showing her on purpose? Was
it
instead of thinking, oh, that was just him naturally putting his arm up and she just happened to look up.
Right, right.
I think that it was just they were kind of making it pointed so that we would realize this is going to play in.
Right.
You know, a little foreshadowing.
So did we cover it all?
I don't know.
Kind of feels like we did. I mean, there's a lot of little things going on throughout. Yeah, I think we're pretty good on this episode. I think that I'm dying to see what happens next. I mean, we thought we were going to do a couple of weeks. I think we're going to binge through this thing in a couple of days.
What do you think is going to happen with Coates and Doggett? Because he's sitting there watching her all the time now, and she's the only one who knows he's up there.
Maybe it'll be like the pact, and he'll just live in the rafters of the prison for the rest of his life.
But what do you think is going to happen? I'm ignoring that.
I know.
What do you think?
I don't know. Like I said, I mean, she's going to be in there a while. Maybe he'll get the help he needs.
No, that's not what I'm talking about. In the immediate, he's in the freaking rafters.
Right, and he's following her, watching her.
They don't know there's another guard.
Yeah, something's going to happen where he's going to fall through that ceiling or something. Something's going to happen, guaranteed. And
so you have no guesses?
I have no guesses, other than he's going to fall through.
Okay.
That's what I think. Right now, he's kind of like Die Hard. You know, because Die Hard climbed through the building. He was through all the, you know, the air ducts and everything. Same kind of thing. Die Hard.
Right. Oh, there are so many, though.
Like so many what?
Where they do that, crawling through.
No, Die Hard's the one. Oh, yeah, where they fall through? Yeah. Yes.
Breakfast Club.
Maybe that's what they're doing. Maybe she's...
Well, you know, the letter was Breakfast Club.
She's Sam...
No, when they read,
Davis Baker Jr.
When they read the list of demands, I was sitting there going, "Oh, this is Breakfast Club," and that was giving me feels. But when they were saying, you know, to whom it may concern, and then they talked about all, and it was very, very touchy feel, and I was like, "Oh, they're doing the thing from Breakfast Club."
They should have ended it with Tasty thrusting her fist up in the air, and then a freeze frame.
Well, the season's not over yet.
No, but just this episode. This was the Breakfast Club.
No, how do you know every episode is in Breakfast Club?
Oh.
I just noticed it.
This could be season 5, The Breakfast Club. Okay. I'm with you. And Caputo's the, you know, you mess with the bull, you get the horns.
Yeah.
I like it. Mm-hmm. Coates then would be that weird janitor guy. Because I think he'd be climbing through the air ducts.
Yeah, that's true. I see that.
Yeah.
Yeah. And so then Judy would be the kid going, I don't want to go. I want to stay here with you guys.
That's the wrong movie, too.
Oh, that was 16 Candles.
That's what I did to Sammy Davis Baker Jr. with 16 Dang Candles it. Also. At least we're not doing Dutch, so.
I wouldn't be able to.
See? It's like the one I don't know.
For obvious reasons.
It's supposed to be good.
We've seen it.
I have not seen Dutch. No.
I have.
Well, you saw Curly Sue, too, and I've never seen it.
I love that bathtub.
I know you love that movie.
No, I love the bathtub.
What?
The bathtub.
The bathtub.
I watched that movie because of the bathroom with the big bathtub in the middle of it.
We watch movies for very different reasons.
Yeah. I want that bathtub.
Okay. All right.
Yeah. I endure the rest of the movie so I can watch that apartment.
Listen, 99%er. Yes. You don't need to go showing it off.
Oh, gosh. Yeah.
That you have these dreams of a bathtub.
I'm clearly not. Well, I have a bathtub, but I want that bathtub.
Like I said, 99%er. Yeah. You're going to have to work to get that.
Oh.
All right. I think we covered it all. I'm gonna wrap it up. We good?
Well, okay. Wait. I know one.
Nope. Got it. Go.
Judy ran and almost got out, and they just pulled her off the fence. And yes. What do you think they're going to do to her?
I think they're just going to, maybe they'll tie her up and take her back in or something. They're going to drag her back in.
You think they're roughing her up?
It didn't look like they were really roughing her up because they would have been kicking and stuff. I think they're just trying to take control of her. Then they'll get her back inside. Maybe they'll tie her to a chair or something, you know, make her a hostage.
They could put her in with the guards.
Yeah, they could.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, I think that's what's going to go on there.
All right.
You good?
I think so.
All right. I'm going to false start again. Are you going to have one more?
No.
Okay. So, couple quick things we've been saying each time. Follow us on our new Instagram. It is Orange Podcast. Follow us on Twitter at Orange Podcast. We always said it wrong the past like 4 years too, by the way. We always said Orange Pod. It's Orange Podcast. Follow us on Facebook. Look for Orange is the New Black Podcast. And if you listen on iTunes, on Stitcher, on Google Play, on TuneIn Radio, wherever you listen to it, please take a minute, give us a rate, give us a review. It really, really helps. It helps drive us up the charts for them so more people will find the show. That's if you like it. If you don't like it, do the same thing and then suggest your enemies listen to us. That's always a good tactic. All right, I'm done. Martha, you're done?
Yep, good.
That's it. Until next time, inmates, back to yourselves.